Dear colleagues, dear colleagues, the theme of my presentation is instability of the contact discontinuity in the presence of density inhomogeneities. The main goals of my presentation is the study of the interface evolution between the two semi-infinite colliding mediums in the presence of density inhomogeneities, the study of nonlinear interactions, and comparison of numerical and theoretical results. In the paper of Velikovich, it's noticed that in such case, the interface is unstable. And this type of instability is named Riksmayer-Mishkov-like instability. But no analysis is given. Following the paper of Burning and Rubenchik, we analyze the development of hydrodynamic instability at the interface in the nonlinear approximations up to the third order corrections to hydrodynamic quantities. Consider the problem statement. The impactor collides with the target. Velocity of the colliding is order of kilometers per second. Interface is flat and density inhomogeneities locate in impactor at initial. Inhomogeneities is of harmonic type and characterized by the angle between wave vector k0 and x-axis. This axis normal to unperturbed shock front. For the reason of high velocity, the elastoplastic properties of can be neglected and problem can be described by the equations of hydrodynamic. There are two shock waves in impactor and in target propagating from contact discontinuity in opposite directions. Additionally to hydrodynamic equations, we consider Rankine-Hugoniot conditions on shock waves 1 and 2 and boundary conditions on contact discontinuity. Equation of state in Mie-Grünheisen form is used to describe material behavior. In linear approximation, solution for hydrodynamic equations can be represented by a set of entropy vortex and sound waves. Entropy vortex wave move with environment velocity, and in other words, entropy vortex wave is frozen in environment. In the other hand, sound wave move with speed of sound, and sound wave can be reflected and refracted on contact discontinuity. Refracted sound wave interact with shock wave in target that results in the formation of new sound and entropy vortex waves. Reflected sound wave also interacts with shock wave in impactor, and that results in formation of new sound and entropy vortex wave, and so on. It's important to know that only set of entropy vortex waves provide instability of contact discontinuity. And sound waves cause only oscillations. In our previous works, we have shown that there is the region of initial angle theta 0, for which the solution includes only entropy vortex waves in shocked area of impactor. This theoretical result is confirmed by direct numerical simulations. This figure corresponds to calculation with sound waves are present in target and in impactor. And this figure corresponds to the calculation when sound wave present only a limited area behind shock front of in impactor. In what follows, we choose this region for simplicity of our theoretical analysis. The results of linear analysis is that spike and bubble velocity are equal and constant in time. But as well known, linear analysis is not enough for correct description of instability development. Considering quadratic corrections, we use hydrodynamic equations, boundary conditions on contact discontinuity, and results of linear analysis. As a result, we obtain the quadratic corrections to x velocity of contact discontinuity is linearly proportional to the time. And therefore, model of quadratic corrections to constant contact discontinuity velocity and velocity itself increases infinitely with time. This fact is not observed in our numerical calculations. That's why we take into account cubic corrections. As a result of similar analysis, we obtained the cubic correction to x velocity of contact discontinuity is quadratically proportional to the time. Finally, quadratic proportion to the time. Finally, the expression for contact discontinuity velocity, contact discontinuity x velocity, is given by the formula. The presence of correction proportional to the time squared can provide, but not necessarily, the point of extremum. Following the work of Burning and Rubenchik, we name this point as saturation point of growth. After saturation time moment, the growth velocity is considered constant. In addition, analysis of plate collision is carried out numerically. The statement of the problem is schematically presented in the figure. Impactor, target, and initial parameters can be represented here. On the slide, we present density profiles for sequential time moments, demonstrating instability development, including later nonlinear stages. Firstly, we note that spike and bubble growth are different. This result can be obtained in two linear analysis. Secondly, the direction of growth spike and bubble is correlated with strip-like initial inhomogeneities. The theoretical analysis up to the third order gives following dependencies for bubble and spike velocities. It's clear that bubble saturation time can be defined uniquely, point of extremum. see that red line on left figure, what, this point. Comparing the theoretical and numerical bubble position, one can see that good agreement is reached. What, theoretical straight line and numerical dashed line. In opposite to that, spike saturation time is undefendable. Because the extremum point lies out of the physical time range. For example, we try 2, 1, and 2 values for spike saturation time and compare theoretical spike position with the numerical one. One saturation time point and second. One can observe that there is good agreement only for early stage of the instability development. The question about spike saturation remains to be opened. Next, we want to compare a new type of instability, Rykhmayer-Mishkov-like instability, with the classical Rykhmayer-Mishkov instability. There too, we set density inhomogeneities in impact in tessellate-like mode. Form. In order to make instability development symmetric. Three left figure demonstrates the contact discontinuity for different theta 0 at the same time moment. It's important to note that bubble growth in case of Rykhmayer-Mishkov-like instability, three left pictures, slows down when it starts to interact with the Nagy-Boring entropy vortex cells. What entropy vortex cells? This one, this one, this one. The most right figure is the Rykhmayer-Mishkov instability calculation with the same value of instability factor. It's clear that mechanism of Rykhmayer-Mishkov instability and Rykhmayer-Mishkov-like instability development is different. Finally, we present instability development for different cases and the dependencies for the mixing zone width. Comparing cases 1 and 2, which differ only by the form of initial inhomogeneities, tessellate-like and strip-like, we note following fact. At the early stage of instability development, mixing zone width is the same for the both cases. What early stage? Case 1 and 2. At later stage, the difference is due to interaction of the bubble with the Nagy-Boring entropy vortex cell in the case 2. This bubble interacts with Nagy-Boring entropy vortex cell. This interaction slows down the bubble growth in case 2, but the spike growth is equal for both cases. Also, we see that mixing zone width strongly depends on the value of theta 0. See this figure. It's important to note that theta 0 defines not only the size of entropy vortex cells, but also initial velocity of spike and bubble. The velocity is greater as theta 0 is greater. And finally, conclusion. We describe contact discontinuity stability in the presence of density inhomogeneities. For this, we use nonlinear analysis up to third order corrections to hydrodynamic quantities. Theoretical results of our analysis for bubble growth is in a good agreement with numerical calculations. The question about spike growth is open. quantity characteristics is of instability development strongly depends on angle of initial homogeneities. Thank you for your attention. Wave vector and normal to shock front.
Normal to shock front?
Yes.
And shock propagates?
Yes.
First of all, I don't understand. In what? It is not decrease. It is a radian measure or what? Radian has to
do. Yes, yes, radian. In radians. This.
So 1.4 means almost 90 degrees?
Yes, so normal. Close to normal, yes.
Close to normal?
Yes, yes.
I don't get pictures. It is all the here, for example. They all are normal to the surface. So it is.
No. One close to normal and.
So we should.
It's. Как? Скользящий. Скользящий. Normal and wave vector parallel to amplitude shock front. Set a zero this angle, but no this. Yes, 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 yes. Yes. Well, this angle is normal. Set a zero.
Как сказать,
практически.
Практика.
One point four. This angle, как скользящий. 90.
Как?
Инцидент. Shock front,
yes.
Wave vector,
yes.
Set a zero,
yes.
Set a zero,
one.
Practically normal, set a zero.
But if it is 4.8, it is somewhere higher.
Okay, so yes.
0.785.
Yes.
It should be inclined at 45 degrees.
Yes.
But it is not inclined.
This tesselite type, we initial homogeneities is sum of two cosinus. Is tesselite type structure no strip line? It's tesselite type.
Okay.
Initial structure.